Very good morning, dear students. Let us today introduce engineering graphics, one subject for first year engineering student. My name is Professor Ajay Kale. I am working as an associate professor in mechanical department, Vishwakarma Institute of Information Technology, Pune. If you see the engineering graphics one examination scheme, there are three types of the examination. Phase 1 is offline of 25 marks, duration will be 1 hour. Units 1 and 2 are included in phase 1 examination. Phase 2, again it is offline examination carrying 25 marks, duration is 1 hour, and units 3 and 4 are included in that. Phase 3 examination is nothing but the theory paper of 50 marks. Duration is 2 hours and all the 6 units will be included in that phase 3 examination. Teaching scheme, there will be 3 lectures per week and of course the practical of 2 hours per week. The course objectives are to develop imagination of physical objects to be represented on paper for engineering communication. Second course objective is to develop manual drawing skill as well as drawing interpretation skill. And the last objective is to develop the physical realization of the dimension of the objects. This is the syllabus for Savitribai Phule Pune University. Unit 1 includes fundamentals of engineering drawing, projections of points and lines, and projections of line. All these are included in unit number 1. In this presentation, our idea is to understand fundamentals of engineering drawing. Unit number 2, projection of planes. Unit number 3, projections of solids. Unit number 4, engineering curves and development of solids. Unit 5, orthographic views or projections. And unit number 6, isometric projection or views. These are the 6 topics which are mentioned in Pune University Engineering Graphics Credit Pattern 2016 syllabus. Term work is also associated with engineering graphics. Every student is expected to draw minimum 6 sheets where 4 problems will be given by the concerned batch in charge. They have to solve it in the sketchbook and to the scale minimum 2 problems on each these 6 units which are mentioned here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Minimum 2 problems are to be drawn on the A2 size sheet. The textbook as per the Pune University syllabus is Engineering Graphics 1 by Arunoday Kumar, TechMax Publication, Pune. This is with respect to syllabus and there are number of solved examples in that. Reference books which are available in VIIT library are like R.K. Dhawan, Engineering Drawing, S. Chand and Company, New Delhi, Revised Edition 2012. And one another reference book is there, that is Engineering Drawing by N.D. Bhatt. This slide is important. Ask each student to purchase these drawing instruments at the beginning of the teaching learning scheme so that they will be conversant with all the topics of Engineering Graphics 1. Drawing sketchbook of A3 size, that is 28 by 40 centimeter, minimum 100 pages are required so that they can draw to the scale problems or they can solve to the scale problem in the class as well as in the drawing hall. In the drawing hall, drawing clips, mini drafter, eraser, scales 6 and 12 inch, clutch pencils HB and H of 0.5 mm diameter, small and large size of compass which is shown in here, protractor inscribed in set square, roll and draw instrument that is optional. They have to purchase minimum 12 different A2 size drawing sheets. A2 size means half imperial sheets, and of course the drawing sheet container to keep the drawing sheets in a neat way. This is the slide that shows the mini drafter. How to adjust the mini drafter will be discussed by the concerned practical batch in charge during the first practical session itself. This is the overall idea about the phase 1 examination, where there will be two questions on line with option of 1 as well as 2. Each carries 12 marks, and another two questions will be there. Question number 3 and 4, both are of 13 marks and both are on the topic plane. Effectiveness of graphic language, or the significance, importance of the engineering graphics to all the engineering student irrespective of branch. Please see this particular diagram or this particular industrial product. If you want to produce this particular product, then it is impossible to describe it in a text or in the word form. Almost 4 or 5 pages of information will be needed to define and manufacture this particular product with correct dimensions. And therefore, it is required to draw engineering drawing in order to describe this particular product. Engineering graphics techniques are used in automobiles, production, as well as manufacturing of each and every component. If you see this particular diagram of the automobile chassis, it is impossible to produce such the products in mass quantity unless and until engineering drawing skills are to be used. Engineering graphics is not applied only to mechanical or production or manufacturing. It is also applied to electronics or computer, that means circuit branches. If I want to draw the diode or the circuit diagram with the actual number of components, here also the engineering graphics skill is needed. Manufacturing of various electronics parts like diodes, transistors, and different electronic gadgets, the 3D model or two-dimensional model cannot be produced unless and until the correct size engineering drawing is drawn. Therefore, graphic language is nothing but the engineer's language. Any object, three-dimensional object, we can represent it by the different lines or the planes to indicate the surface of that component or the edge of that particular three-dimensional component. To draw any engineering drawing, it is necessary to understand the basic line types and their names. This visible line, which is continuous, is used to show the feature or the outline of any object, whereas comparatively thin line is used to represent the dimension or the extension or the leader line. Hidden lines are also used in order to represent those features of object which are not visible either in the front view or in the top view or in the side view. And if the object is symmetrical, लाइक सिलेंडर और सर्कुलर होल और द स्फीयर द सेंटर लाइन इज रिक्वायर्ड इन द ड्रॉइंग इटसेल्फ. ऑल दीज लाइन्स आर इलेबोरेटेड इन द एनी टेक्स्ट बुक. द स्टूडेंट्स आर एडवाइज टू रेफर एंड स्टडी द नेचर ऑफ डिफरेंट लाइन्स by studying the textbook. This is one example of the component which is represented on the drawing. You can see it here. To understand the distance between the two circles, dimension lines are used, extension lines are also used, the leader lines are used to understand the curve or radius feature that is provided to the component. And the visible line is nothing but the outline of the object. There are two methods which are usually used according to the orientation to give the dimensions to the drawing which is drawn on the drawing sheet. One method is called as align method, and throughout this particular course we are going to use the align method, where the dimension figures are placed so that they are readable from the bottom or right side of the drawing. Unidirectional method is also there. The dimension figures are placed so that they can be read from the bottom of the drawing. Aligned system, you can see it here. In the aligned system, the dimension lines are full, and the number is kept at the usually at the center and at the top of the line. The height dimensions are to be mentioned at the right or left side, again by the full lines with correct position of arrows, and the dimension number or the dimensions are to be provided in the center, and usually millimeter is the size that is used to indicate the size of the feature in the engineering drawing. Whereas in unidirectional system, the dimensions are provided again at the center, but the dimension line is break up into two parts, and in between the dimension line the number is placed. There are few rules of dimensionings. Between any two extension lines, there must be one and only one dimension line bearing one dimension. Again, you refer the book in order to understand the rules of dimensioning. All these rules are given in the textbook. There are the arrowheads, and the dimension line positions are also important. Where we are supposed to draw the dimension line in any engineering drawing, you can see it here. The dimension line should be very thin in comparison with the outline. It should be placed 6 to 8 mm away from either at the bottom or at the side of the main feature or the outline of the drawing. And then the extension line, this is to be extended minimum 3 millimeter so that the dimension line will be visible in this particular way. Do not provide the arrows in your engineering drawing like open arrows or closed type of arrows. This is the wrong way. But the filled up arrows are necessary, like this one. And the typical dimension is, like suppose if this is the width, then the length or the breadth should be thrice that of the width. Means if this is 2 millimeter, this distance should be 6 millimeter. First angle method of projection, which we are going to use throughout this particular course. This projection is usually used in the Europe. You know first